This is a very, very special. Well, you're my officially my first guest. I do have my engineer, Tad Bonkers, coming in, and he's been my guest, but you are officially my first guest.
It's such an honor. Thank you.
Yeah. And we worked this out. And then we're going to be featuring some other local artists.
Yeah, I'd love that. All right. Thank you.
Yeah, so we'll take it all the way till 4 o'clock. And if Rachel can stay a little bit longer, we're going to push it a little bit. Okay. Because I want to have a good long hour with her. But anyway, so I'm going to push that button right now. And you're going to hear Rachel recorded.
Wake up in the morning, all stars have gone to bed. All my dreams of you are hung back inside my head. I try and remember everything that you said, but your words have sunk back into the sand.
Shut up, cloud. extreme conditions.
So, Rachel, you know that I am not a Hallmark holiday girl, okay? But today is the last day of Women's Month.
Oh, yeah.
And, okay, it's also Easter.
Every month is Women's History Month for us. Yeah.
That's what I was going to say. So it doesn't really matter that we're, you know, that we're featuring... kind of leaning towards featuring women artists, but I figured, well, since it was the last day and, you know, people are always asking me, what kind of theme are you doing? And I said, well, it has a little something to do with women, but you know what? We don't ever exclude the men, you know, because they help to define, they give us the inspiration, right? And I loved that we were just talking about how you had your album release, and you also had some art that you were showing and that you were doing a collaboration with my husband, Mike Steele.
Yeah.
and the thing is that was what tickled me the most about when I was following what you were doing. I'm like, oh my gosh. You know, it's such a joy. It's such a joy to be able to partner with, you know, these creative, these projects.
Yeah. So my husband's background is urban planning and cartography. And if you see maps or infographics in the paper for the last 20 years, there's a chance that he made them. Like that's what he does. And he works for the governor now. I've been for the last 20 years working at the U of C as a graphics person. So that's what I do as my day job. But this is the first time we've collaborated in a way that in an art way about my music. So It was really nice to do that with him. And I hope we do more.
Yeah. And you had your album release at Fitzgerald's.
That's right, on Thursday.
Yeah. I love Fitzgerald. It's it's such a wonderful institution. And I heard that the place was packed.
Yeah, we sold out.
And you featured a lot of other musicians that you work with.
Absolutely. We were so thrilled to be joined by Chloe Orwell and Wally Rozak and the wonderful Gerald Dowd, who's a genius in all ways, who was also playing next door and then came and joined us on percussion.
And you brought some music in with you, as promised.
I did. Yes.
And we are going to be featuring local Chicago music, I don't know, for the next 20, 30 minutes.
Yeah, thank you, Diane.
Yeah, you're welcome. So the last couple songs you heard was Rachel Drew from her latest release, which is called Old Sky New. And it was In My Heart, or If My Heart Was Made For You. And that was one that I always loved.
Thanks, so, Diane.
So you made that suggestion that I should cue that one up.
That's Chloe Orwell on sax as the whole horn section, right? Isn't that amazing?
Amazing.
Mm-hmm.
I love her too. So yeah. Shout out to Chloe.
Yeah.
And we're going to be playing some Handcuffs coming up, right?
Yeah, I brought a CD in and I'd love to... Yeah, I'd love to do that.
All right. So we also heard John Langford sandwiched in between Rachel Drew. We did Somewhere Waiting for Me, but we wanted to play some vinyl in between, and that was Only Demons.
Only Demons, yeah. I got to sing that a few times with John and John at various shows, and it's always a joy to play with them, so I brought that in.
All right. So we're going to get back to some more music. I have something a little delightful. This is a dedication to some of my childhood. I'm going to call them my sisters. And, oh, hey, we have another one of our friends in. Tad Bonkers, welcome.
Howdy.
You get to finally meet Rachel Drew in person.
Oh, Rachel.
There she is.
Thank you so much.
All right, so while we do this introduction here, I'm going to play a little music, and then we're going to come back to some of Rachel's. We have to start that over.
Mr., do you like cannolis?
I can't, but thank you very much. I appreciate it.
Stay and kindly satisfy.
I like the theme of the last set. It goes from I Want to Know Everything.
Naomi Ashley.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I'm Happy Just to Dream with You, and then I'm Through with Loving You.
Yeah, it's a whole story.
Yeah, right. And so, yes, and also a whole story of some of our friends.
Yes.
And collaborators. Naomi Ashley.
Yeah.
We love her. We all love her here. Naomi, hopefully you're listening.
John Williams, Josh Pyatt, Jason Batchko. They're all on that.
They're all on that. And then we heard The Handcuffs. Mm-hmm. That was Chloe.
Chloe Orwell,
and Company.
Brad Elvis.
Yes. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And that was I'm Happy Just to Dream with You. And then we followed up with Tim Menard.
That's right.
Yeah. I'm Through with Loving You. Shout out to Tim.
Shout out to Tim.
Yeah. And then we're going to play some more from your latest release that anyone can get. You want to tell them how they can get your music?
Yeah, you can find me streaming anywhere. If you punch in my name, Rachel Drew, you can order a CD or an art print or a t-shirt if you go to my website, racheldrew.com.
You're actually pretty easy to find.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I try. You are
posting some really great things. I love your videos. They're so beautiful.
Thank you, Diane.
And, you know, I work in film, and I have done some music videos. And when I saw those, I mean, it was just one after another a couple months ago. I hadn't seen all of those, and they are excellent production. Beautiful.
Thank you.
And you look wonderful.
Oh, so do you.
Thank you. Okay, we're going to take a picture of us here to show you how wonderful we look.
We're going to strip first.
That's right. We're going to dance. Yeah. We'll turn the lights down in here, too. See, yeah. It's way different when we just have, like, the neon glow, mm-hmm. right, accentuating those things. And
those things.
You know, whatever. No, we were also trying to think of, we're celebrating so many things. Some of you are celebrating, you know, Easter, okay, duh, Easter dinner and however else that you might observe. And then some of us are just celebrating the eve of April Fool's Day.
Ah, getting ready. Getting ready to fool some people.
Yeah, and I'm not ready. I have to come up with something.
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh. I was going to, Tad Bonkers is in the wings, and I told him maybe he can come up with something before the end of our show.
Well, toilet themed pranks are always a winner.
Toilet themed pranks.
It was saran wrap on top.
What? Oh my gosh. Oh, okay.
Freezing items that shouldn't be frozen, and then just general creating chaos and confusion.
Or starting false rumors about ourselves.
Uh-oh.
That's what me and my girlfriends used to do back here in the day at Lake Forest College on this very campus.
Wow.
Yeah, yeah. We would. I think it was right around April Fool's Day that we would start them and just see how quickly it would take to get back to us.
Hmm. So how many boyfriends did you get out of it?
Or how many did I lose? They're like, I don't know if I want to get involved with that.
I started the rumor, isn't it funny?
Yeah, and you know, somehow it was like they were believable. So then, you know, anyway. So shout out to my gal pals. We're celebrating our milestone. I'm not going to say the number, but we're celebrating our milestone anniversary. And so I made sure that they would all be listening. So, and I would love to just say that you can all check in with me on Sunday Dinner with Di. That's on Facebook. And please follow, share with your friends. That's what this is all about. You know, want to bring everybody to the table. And this is a good way to be with our friends, you know, far and wide, because we're broadcasting worldwide. Do you know that I have friends listening right now in London?
Wow.
Yeah.
London.
Who's listening to you right now? You gave a little shout out to some people.
I did. I know. Shout out to Kathy Kelly. She said she was going to set a timer and listen to us. So I hope she is. Uh-huh. We love Kathy Kelly.
All right. Kathy Kelly. Was she taking a nap? And she said she was going to wake herself up.
I hope she was taking a nap.
Well, the good news is that I've got this recorded. Mm-hmm. So on another occasion, we'll be able to do a rebroadcast. Probably not on, you know, at this time slot, but, and it will be available for the archives. All right. And, you know, I don't know for what else. We could take little snippets.
For history.
For history. Yeah. We'll remember this moment. So anyway, all right, so I want everybody to stay tuned. You know where you are. You're listening to WMXM, either on the .org worldwide, or if you're local, 88.9 FM. I love that you're here. We're going to take this a little bit past the top of the hour, and my really quick public service announcement is, as always, go out and support your artist friends. Go support local music live in person, or, you know, you can also buy, you yeah. know, right?
It's important.
It really is.
It makes things happen.
Yeah. And it brings passion to, you know, the performances. And I'm so happy that you had a wonderful release over at Fitzgerald's, even though I couldn't be there.
Well, man, we missed you. And in fact, we had a moment of silence in the middle of the show. We shouted out to you. You didn't answer. And then we all cried. Everyone in the room. And then the show resumed.
I did send a representative. So I was like, how's it going? So, yeah, you know, we can't always be there, but at least try and be there in spirit.
Right.
And I just say, yeah, show up when you can. And, you know, there will be another time. And I'm so glad that you would join me here. It means the world to me. All right. And it means the world to me that we have the support of my wonderful engineer and friend, Tad Bonkers. All right. And another shout out to Craig, who is recording this. So yay for all of us. Mm-hmm. All right. So some more Rachel Drew, and then I'm going to push it. I think we've got a couple more things that we're going to play from your, you know, what's in the bag.
My bag of records.
Mm-hmm. So maybe that's what will be a little bit of an April Fool's surprise. All right. It'll surprise me. All right. This one you're going to really like.
No one else I'd rather see. No other kind of make-believe. When I dream of you, you make my blue skies blue. Dream of you, far away, close in my mind. Oh,
super careful not to talk over Olivia, right? Oh, yeah. The dulcet tones of Olivia Newton-John.
Like listening to a cloud that has gold on it.
Mm. And she's forever our angel now up in the cloud with
That's
gold.
Right.
Yeah. Romantic stuff. And now, because I didn't get a chance to put it in there, you're going to have to help me.
I will.
We did, before that, we played The Handcuffs. And also Rachel Drew.
Who?
Yeah, you. When I Dream of You. And then we played The Handcuffs. And then what else am I missing? Well, then we played Linda Ronstadt.
Linda Ronstadt, yeah, Tim Menard, Naomi Ashley, John Lankford, and the Fancy Men. And, you know, there are more people that I would have wanted to bring in. I could not find their CDs. So Peter Jolie is one of those people.
Well, maybe we have to have you come
Gerald
back.
Gerald Dowd. I don't know where his stuff is. Yeah, Al Rose is great.
Oh, well, we might have some Gerald Dowd around here. We could always look.
Yeah.
You know, we could always look people up if we want to stay here for another hour. But we'll bring her back, okay? We had to do this as quickly as possible. I was so excited about Rachel's latest album release, and I wanted somebody wonderful and like a close friend that I could have as my first official rock star guest on the show since coming back. And, you know, I think it went all right. I'm at one with, you know, with sharing the mic.
Thank you. It's beautiful.
Yeah. It's a good
and
thing.
So is your shirt.
Oh, you like this?
Well, I was instructed to trash talk it. By Tad Bonkers, but I chose not to.
Well,
it'll cost me $2. He promised to pay me if I trash talked it.
How could you trash talk? This is so normal.
It's very beautiful.
Yeah, it's not. It's beautiful. Well, you know,
because we can say anything.
Because for all they know,
because
we have
radio.
The night. Yeah, we don't know what we're really wearing.
Yeah, that's true.
We could be like naked DJs. I just leave you with that image right now.
That could be your next, you know,
my next
phase.
Theme.
Yeah,
phase.
Yeah, phase.
Yeah. So that my next guest will have to have it. turn the lights down low. We're having a good time here, all right? And we're so glad that you stayed with us, because we wanted to go a little, you know, dip into the next hour. And we wish you, wherever you are, you and your loved ones, you know, wish you a beautiful, wonderful Sunday. And I hope that you will mark your calendars, because I'll be here next Sunday, same time, same place, for now. And if I can, you know, push it, I'll do a longer shift, you know, next week too. We'll see what I can
do. Tune in, everybody.
Yeah, tune in. Tell your friends. And we will be having some other guests that with a fairly, you know, regular, I don't know, at least every other week, I'm going to have some people in. Vinny, did you hear that?
And I just heard someone yell, yes.
Yeah.
From several miles away.
Right? I feel it. And actually, there are several other people that have promised. My friend Dave Olson. Do you know him?
Yeah.
You know Gizmo? He's going to, you know.
He's the sweetest.
He is. Yeah. He said he wants to be my helper 1 week.
Oh, lovely.
Yeah. And there will be more. So, and I will be keeping you posted on the Facebook page, Sunday Dinner with Di, where you are also welcome to give me your feedback or make any requests, dedications, and I try and fit them in the next show, because it's kind of hard to do on the live show,
mm-hmm.
You know, because this is for real. We're really live.
Yeah, and we are sort of in a like a bomb shelter almost, so it's a little bit hard to post or do anything or receive
it, even like reach me.
Yeah,
how about that? Rachel was trying to meet me here, and I couldn't even ping her and tell her where I was. But you found me.
I did.
You
yeah.
found me. I sent out like the what's Batman? What does he put out there? The bat. What is he? What does he call it? The bat light? I don't know.
Yeah, that's true. I saw it. I also asked several students.
Did you? And yeah. did they know?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Well,
right.
A couple of people who worked here didn't know, but the students.
The students knew.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. I They see me sometimes. They know that this is going on. So, hey, shout out to all the students here at Lake Forest College. I love that I especially love when you're listening. See, when the kids are coming back from spring break or from their Easter break. All right, so back to a little bit more music. We'll say goodbye one more time.
Okay.
So you have one more chance in case there's some other thoughts.
Oh, boy. Just, I love you, Diane, and it's nice to see you. And it's nice to see you on your turf. It's always out at shows that I see you.
I know.
Or dancing.
I'm sneaking in and I pass by you and wave while you're on stage. Or
we dance together while other people
are
on
stage. We've done that.
There are pictures. There are sweaty pictures of that.
Yeah.
So thank you for having me. Matt Greenberger posts them on my timeline on Facebook every time I have a birthday.
I was going to say for your birthday.
It's a picture of us sweating on a dance floor.
That way you know that it's real. Otherwise, we would not have that sweat.
That's true. I would never post that picture.
That's right. Right. And actually, that's how I get my workout.
Yeah.
Yeah. About like three. Okay. So when I say to you, get out there and see and hear live music, that's the other public service announcement. You can get into shape. You know, get on the dance floor. And also, when you're on the dance floor, have a couple dollars on you to put in the tip jar.
Oh, that's not where I thought you were going with that.
That's usually what happens.
Yeah.
We think I'm going down like a certain path. Well, and then this one over here stops me.
Yeah.
Yeah, in my tracks. And yeah, you thought it was going to go in the...
Well, for you. I thought it was for... The dollars were for you.
The dollars could be for me.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'll collect them.
You won't say no.
I won't say no.
Yeah.
All right.
Well, you asked me to pick a track, and yes. I picked a Ceremony from New Order. This is the song that when I was 11 years old, it made me want to be a drummer. But we lived in an apartment, so that didn't happen. But I loved.
Was that the first thing that you were going to play? I know you come from a musical family.
Yeah, this New Order in general made me want to be a drummer. And I know that that's not usually the band that maybe makes people want to be a drummer.
Well, I'm going to say that New Order made me get out on the dance floor.
Yeah, there you go.
So, yeah, it makes us do things. All right, so hit the button.
Okay.
We're doing it. Here you go. Rachel's passion. Here we go. Crackle pop. Pop, pop.
It's real. It's old.
Thank you.
Is that a real drummer?
It's a real drummer.
All right. So thank you for that new order. It brought us, you know.
We feel closer now.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, because honestly, when I would be in, and I'm a little bit older than you, so I was in the nightclubs when this was, when this came out.
Right.
And as soon as I would hear it, it was like the bar stool started bouncing around, and I had to get on the dance floor. It was compelling. So, and you started being something of a percussionist.
Well, I never really, I mean, now I do it because I'm standing there with it in my hand. So that, I think that makes me a percussionist because I'm doing it, but really I'm a singer songwriter.
Well, I know that.
But as a kid, yeah, that was the thing I was drawn to at first.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I brought a couple egg shakers in.
Let's do it.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. So we're going to join in on this final cut. This is Rachel brought in a selection of some of her favorites. Those were the instructions when I woke her up this morning. And I said, bring your favorite music, bring some selections, whatever you want to play. We're going to give you a couple sets. And so I started this show with Godspell. And that was actually something that I was going to do. And then when I was asking for requests earlier in the week, this is what came back.
Wow.
For the Easter show. Yeah. A couple people said, I want to hear some Godspell. So anyway, we started off with that. I've been living Godspell all week, by the way. All right. And my friends have been having to live with it, too.
Are you all following
I'm a hippie
a messiah,
girl.
Or?
Yeah. No, no. It's just I like that kind of, I like musicals.
Oh, I do, too. Yes, I do, too.
Yeah. I like musicals. So anyway, so I've been into that. I've been thinking about like the big fro that the Jesus character, you know, wears in the Godspell.
Thinking about
and then we decided that the last song that we're going to play, it's a nice bookend.
It's from Hair. It's
the soundtrack from Hair.
Yeah.
Which also has a big fro on the cover.
Yeah. So when I was 15 years old, I was in Hair and I sang a few of the songs, and that was my first time singing in front of
big, is this the one the crowds. One that we're gonna play, is that
well one? I wasn't on Broadway. No.
No, I mean,
yeah, this is
the song that you did.
Oh, I didn't sing this one, but I always loved it. This song, What a Piece of Work Is Man, has come up in my life over and over. Like, for example, 8 days after I had my first kid, we had a house fire, and there was an electrical fire in the building. We were standing outside watching it burn. Everyone was fine, but it was quite an upheaval. This song wouldn't leave my mind for like 4 days following. It just on, you know, sometimes when you learn these songs very early, like I learned the whole album, they stay with you. And this is one of those.
All right. I like Frank Mills. That's the one.
I love Frank Mills too. Do you want to do that instead?
You know what? No.
We can do them both?
We can do them both.
Okay.
We're going to do them both. And you know what? And we're going to be doing Egg Shakers and then DJ Karaoke. So you might hear us singing in the background. That's all I'm saying. All right. So first we're going to do this and then we'll figure out how we can play Frank Mills.
Yeah.
Everyone. All right. Yay. We're having fun.
Electronic data process. internet in faculties, informed and moving, how express and admirable.
Oh, no.
In action, how like an angel. In apprehension, how like a god. The beauty of the world, the paragon of congregation of vapors. What a piece of work is man, how noble in reason.
Yeah, there's definitely a message in that.
It sure is. Yeah, so the actual song that gets caught in my head in these times is "What a Piece of Work Is Man," not the, it just that it shows up halfway through, and right. It's not the first, not
I could first have part. Dropped the needle exactly where that started, but
we got to hear all of it for the historical context.
Yeah
it's Women's History Month, so that's we're all about history right now,
and we only have a couple more hours of that and let's then we're gonna forget them. All about women and back to Men's Month.
No, I'm gonna.
We would not be able to define ourselves without our counterparts. You know,
well,
the male counterpart. You know,
I mean, we're just people, all of us. Yeah, really.
Exactly.
Some of us are this kind of people, and some of us are this kind of people, and mm-hmm. they're all the kinds of people. There are a lot of kinds of people.
Yeah, there's all kinds of people, yeah. And then there's all kinds of names.
All
for
kinds.
People. And so you're going to love this because that's my segue.
Yeah.
My segue into the next song.
Okay.
Because I'm ready. See, I did that. We kind of, you know, did a little riffing there while I was able to cue up this very song that is. Uh-oh. Here we go. This is the last one and saying goodbye.
It's a good one.
It is a good one. And we will be singing in the background.
Frank Mills on September 12th, right here in front of the Waverly. But unfortunately, I lost his address. He was last seen with his friend, a drummer he
appreciate